Everybody, welcome back to the channel. My name is Paul Nguma, founder of Pedology Lab. In today's video, we're going to be talking about the top two stocks that you should be keeping in your watch list for today. And I'm also going to be answering some of you guys' questions for those of you who dropped your stickers, your stock of interest in the comment section of yesterday's video, all right? So let's get started. The very first one, first of all, we gotta talk about the SPY. Let me change the scene really quick, okay? So right off the bat, the SPY is not doing bad at all. I have been telling you guys that we want to test this line, and it looked like we went there overnight, right? We got over here overnight. Now, should you be scared? Honestly, I don't think you should be panicking just yet. I don't think so. I think we're gonna hold steady, and we're just gonna like go like this sideways here for a while. All right, we're gonna go sideways here, and then eventually we're gonna have to pop out of there, okay? Best case scenario. Worst case scenario, this thing just tumbles and just crash all the way to 3,600. Keep that in mind. That can happen. I'm not saying that it will, okay? I'm just saying keep that in mind. We've been testing that level twice now. Maybe a third time would be a charm to break above it. If that third time fell, maybe we might see 3,600. Again, I'm just giving my very honest opinion. Not trying to scare anybody, not trying to scare the longs. Just keep that in mind, okay? Now, the very first stock that you should be keeping in your watch list for today, that stock is Overstock, OSTK. And I like OSTK, especially after what happened yesterday. It had a very strong move yesterday over here, all right? Buyers just kept buying this thing up. And if you look at it on the daily, the stock have been down for so long. I did cover this a long time ago when we were shorting the stock, right? And it went down some more. I told you that I was not bullish on the stock when we were over here because I wanted it to crumble down to like the 60s. And it did. It even went down to the 50s. And it stayed there for a while. And it's been consolidating sideways for a while. I like it because number one, if you look at the bottom, that volume is really good. That volume and that candle is just perfect. And number two, if you're looking at it pre-market, it's up right now. It looks really good. It's a nice setup for a breakout. Keep this one on your watch list for a potential long today. Okay, for a potential long today. How high could it go, honestly? I would love to see it at exactly, I would love to see it at $72 today and then possibly 80 on Friday. If not, then 80 on Monday. I would love to see that. This is setting up kind of good. Okay, so keep that one on your watches for sure. I'm definitely not bearish on it. I don't see any news at all. I really don't. But I'm definitely not bearish on that one. Okay, so watch Overstock for a long. The next one that you should be keeping in your watch list for today is Home, At Home, okay? And I'm sure a lot of you looked at both of these charts and they pretty much look exactly the same, right? There's no difference. All right, let's just go back here. OSTK and then Home. There is no difference whatsoever in these charts, none. Okay, not a surprise here. So keep your eyes peeled on Home for a potential long. Okay, it had a nice day yesterday. Watch this thing for a long. I think the stocks in like the home furniture might have a huge move today. Okay, they're all looking pretty nice. So keep them in your watch list for today. Again, I'm watching them, all right? And I have a position in a few of them already. So keep them in your watch list for sure. Now, let's talk about you guys' stock of interest. Oh, by the way, for Home, where do I see this thing going? I see it going to, I almost forgot about that. I see it going to 20 bucks. 20 bucks probably within this week. If not this week, then next week for sure. I like it. I like the way it's setting up right now. I don't have any issues with it at all. Okay, now let's talk about you guys at Stock Adventures. The very first one that we're going to cover is SSY. I've been getting a lot of requests about regarding SSY. This pattern is it it was claimed before, right? The trade over here was made. And is this bearish? Are we bearish on this one right now? It's about to open at around 70. The pre-market says between 72 and 74. I don't know exactly how it's going to open. The spread is pretty wide, and there is nothing happening over here, but we'll see how it opens. If it opens at exactly 74.22, then this may be a replica of IPOB. All right, I'm pretty much answering two questions right now with just like one play. What I mean by a replica of IPOB is that if you change this thing to a the 1 hour time frame, and we go over here, we can clearly see that there is a bullish pennant on the chart right over here, right? Very nice, very clean trade. It spiked and then it dropped. Okay, this right here is where we are with SYY. So the temptation to quit, the temptation to drop the stock and just move on to something else, is really, really great for a lot of people. All right, it's at that point, it's very great. This variation of the pattern is the most annoying one, and the one that will test your patience a lot. Okay. And if you're holding short-term contracts, that could hurt you because obviously it's options, and options do expire, and especially when they're out of the money, they can expire worthless if the stock is taking too long. So keep that one in your mind as you trade in this one. If you look at IPOB, right, it dropped all the way down and then it had a nice run. Could that happen to SYY? I think it could. But I want to see exactly how it's opening. Even though we're in pre-market right now and the market is opening in about 40 minutes, I can't see any data for this pre-market. So we'll just have to see how it opens. All right. If it opens lower than this, then yeah, I wouldn't have too much confidence in this one. But if it doesn't, and immediately there is a large amount of buyers that bring the stock up to like $76, then I may have some confidence on this one to go up to $85 or $90. Because it is looking like IPOB, even though this is probably the worst the worst variation of the pattern. Yeah, so that's my very honest opinion of these two stocks. Okay, where is this thing gonna go? Where is IPOB gonna go? Honestly, I don't really know, and I don't really care either. The money to be made was over here. After that, like whatever the stock does after that is really none of my issue. If you look on the chart, there is a bearish Harami on there. Keyword bearish Harami. I'm not touching this long. If you find value in the stock, go ahead. If it breaks above the new high, then there may be a short squeeze again because some people might be shorting at the top. Again, if you look at that pre-market, it's opening up slightly higher at 28.20 when they close that 27.88. Okay, so keep that in mind. It may be a move up again. Who knows? Again, but my interest personally was this move right here. That move right there was that was pretty much it. After that, whatever happens is whatever happens. I don't really care anymore. Okay. Now, the next one that we're going to be talking about is DraftKings. And DraftKings, somebody have been asking about DraftKings for a while. I talked about this before, especially after we got to $52, right? And I told you that if I don't know where the stock is going to go, I'm not touching it. Okay. I didn't know where it was going to go at all. And it tried to drop a little bit, but it got bought right back up. And honestly, I wouldn't be surprised to see this thing go sideways for a bit longer. All right, the more it goes sideways, the better. It forms something else that makes it easy for us to know exactly where it's gonna go, whether it's to the upside or whether it's to the downside. But as of right now, I have no clue. I'm not putting my money in this yet until it shows me something worth putting my money into. So, again, that's my very honest opinion of DraftKings. The next one that we're going to be covering is Nike, which is a stock that I covered before when the stock actually broke out. The pattern was very clean and then it started playing games with us, right? So it broke out here and then got back in here, all right, and then dropped a little bit and then went up again. And it's just toying with everybody, short and long. It's just messing with everybody's emotions, ruin everybody's day, right? It's just going like this. This is not what we want. This is very annoying. As you can tell by the way I sound, this is extremely annoying. Okay. Am I bullish on it? Am I still bullish on it? Honestly, I wouldn't short Nike. I wouldn't. I really wouldn't. It's about to open slightly higher. We'll see how it goes. Keep in mind that earnings is right around the corner. Keep that in mind, okay? It could drop all the way to 120 through earnings. I do not condone anybody holding any contracts through earnings at all. If you have some strategy that you want to test out with earnings, again, do what you want to do. Manage your risk going small, because if you're wrong, you're probably gonna lose 80 to 90% of your money on calls or puts if you're wrong. Okay, that's my very honest opinion of Nike for the ones who asked about it. Sure, if you got value from the video, definitely destroy the like button for the YouTube algorithm. As always, if you are new to the channel, definitely click on subscribe and click on the notification bell along with all notifications. That way you get notified whenever I release these pre-market analysis videos, which are released from Monday through Friday at exactly 8:15 a.m. Central Time, 15 minutes before the market opens. And the post-market analysis videos, which are made from Monday to Sunday, every single day in the afternoon. If you're not following us on social media, you can find me at Paul Nguma and at Patternology Lab on Instagram and on Twitter. I posted something on Twitter, by the way. Definitely check that out and also cast your votes. I just want to put that out there. Yeah. And also, if you are a beginner looking to get started in the stock market, I left some step-by-step directions in the description of the video below. Step one through step four, it only takes about 15 minutes or less to get signed up with everything you need, including this charting tool that I'm using, Thinkorswim, to get started in the stock market and to start making trades and making some money. You can also get 3 free stocks after signing up with Webull. Use my very first link in the description below. And 1 free stock after signing up with Robinhood using my second link in the description below as well. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, my name is Paul Nguma with Patternology Lab, where we trade patterns and patterns only. And I will see all of you in the next video. Do not get caught on the wrong side of the trade. The market is up, which is great. Again, keep my opinions about the whole market in mind as you're trading. Home stocks are looking pretty good. I'm gonna see y'all this afternoon.